acrimonious in the ring. He had a chip on his shoulder. They had
Paso, Texas, courtesy of America Presents, and your undisputed King of Beers, Budweiser, we go to the heavyweight division. This bout is scheduled for 8 rounds. The 3 judges assigned to ringside will be Arturo Serin, Levi Martinez, and Frank Adams. And when the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Cherry Wright. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing purple trim with gold and weighing in at 257 pounds. An excellent record of 25 victories, 23 by knockout, with 4 losses. He comes to us by way of Havana, Cuba. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Jorge Luis González. And his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, trimmed with white, and weighing in at 315 pounds. Also an excellent record, 15 victories, 13 by knockout, with only 1 loss. His home is Tonga, New Zealand. Ladies and gentlemen, he is Wolf Brown.
Okay, who's the chief second here? Chief second here? Okay, one man can be in the corner, chief second. Okay, you men are too big for me to manhandle, so I want you to obey my commands, you understand? I can't be pulling you apart. Okay, break and get out of there, I mean break and get out of there. Watch the low blows, watch the clubbing behind the head, watch the kidneys, okay? Good luck, shake hands, come out of the zone.
Now that's excellent instructions, I think, from referee Jerry Wright. Take that out too many referees to pull these guys apart.
He says
push off.
If you listen to Andy Weidman's veterans, this is a sport that is not by a book. The only way you learn it is
being
asked.
Come on.
It's hot.
And there's the first bit of manhandling. Gonzalez trying to throw an uppercut to the body from the outside.
Wolfram
is the guy applying the pressure here in round one and backing up Jorge Luis Gonzalez. He has to, and he has to.
$5 is 83.
That is a And Gonzalez bounced off the ropes in the effect of it. Now trying to dig a left hook to the body was Wolfram, but Gonzalez got a move inside of it.
Ali.
All right, first round in the books.
Come out of that.
Go back to the corner of Wolf Grant. And a third time.
A deep breath. Right. One more. Okay, look. The right hand is what I want, but not strong with the left one. Okay? Now the left one. Now the left is still on the right hand. Give me the left hook. And look at the other left hook, okay? Do not fall. I want you to run around. Start cutting off. Take forward. And when you break, don't take a triple step back. You know? You take one step back. You stay right there. Okay? I want the pressure. I want to keep it tight. Okay?
Going to round two of this heavyweight, and in the amateurs it would be called a super heavyweight to the paddle. Two distinguished amateur players. These guys want to make an impact as professionals. You can see there weren't a lot of punches landed in that round, although Wolfram threw a lot anyway. He landed 15 compared to 10 for Gonzalez, and Wills Lane gave round number one to Wolfram, 10-9 margin. And they wanted to be a little more aggressive in this round, though Torrance's trainer does. He's asking for, he says he wants the right hand, but he wants it to start it with the left hook to the bottom.
Yes, but these heavyweights, in that first round because they realize the significance of this fight and the significance of the win. They can't make any mistakes, especially in this heavyweight division.
Gonzalez in his last fight was KO'd in one round by the preeminent contender, I guess you would call him at this time, young prospect, young contender, being Michael Grant. And then he said in that fight, Gonzalez said, my back is just the move. Can you get out of the way of traffic?
Yeah,
he
was going to do anything
about it. No condition in that fight. He was talking in the first round by Michael Grant. Of course you have no condition. You're in bad condition.
Trying to keep the pressure on. The other thing they wanted to do, Sean, is to not really, when they break, they don't want Wolfram to step back too far. They want to take a quick step or a half step back, and then be right back on the attack.
But you got to protect yourself right back on the attack. And he's in the pressure, but he's putting in the right hand. Wolfram, watch how he drags the left.
All right, let's drag it now.
Move out. Left arm, Wolfram is eating his right hand.
Angler sure helped me about
a lot of clutching going on. See that puffiness underneath the left eye of both grounds. He continues to shuffle in.
Okay, come on, man.
Getting an unusual posture of fighting a guy who's bigger than him, having to get inside a guy whose reach is more than him.
Having to punch up. See, you have more power when you punch down on your opponent.
Okay, you're tied up. Come on,
man. When you punch up, it's a rather unusual trajectory of your punch.
That's
tell you, Wolfram was just an absolute sensation in the Olympic Games, the last Olympics in 96. He beat a Cuban fighter. Nobody expected him to be able to do so, but he beat Alexis Rubalcaba in the quarterfinals. He ended up with the first medal ever won by Chonga. Didn't make it to the gold, but still he won a silver. He was just a sensation. People loved him there.
Said that Alexis was as big as Gonzalez.
Finals.
Rounds in the book. A lot of clutching and holding in that last round.
You're letting him build up a little confidence in him, okay? Okay, when you're inside, let those punches go. Get two or three shots. And finish your shots with your left hand, okay? You throw a hook, come back with the right hand. Okay. Bang, 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 and double up when you're there, okay? And work this guy. Okay? Okay.
Paul Torrance, okay. Again, really he wants pressure, and he says, when you get ready, you're in shape. Start letting those hands go when he gets
one. And take a look at those tree trunks, the legs.
For the first two rounds, they both landed about the same amount of punches, but the Wolf has got a much higher activity level. He keeps pushing the fight, bringing the fight cadence out, and he's landing a lot more punches, but Gonzalez won the second round, and the card of Wolf landed up the fight.
Stellar right hands in that second. He does this. He continues to lay against the ropes back in the
corner. Tied up. Yeah.
That is a horrible impression on the judges. What he tries to do is he leans back against their butt, springs off of them, and then finishes the power of his right hand.
Gonzalez for holding, excessive holding. And they warned him that he would take a point away if he continues to hold the way he is. He goes back into the corner, started to draw a blitzing, and Gonzalez really not fighting a very stimulating fight so far.
Looks like he's struggling. I think this is Gonzalez's
Wolfram's landing some nice little left hooks inside, in close. Right, letting him fight in close, even though he's getting close to or do get tied up. Now finally he'll break.
And that is vintage. I hope you know it's got Torrance training. Keep the pressure on. The little bitty punches, you know, these little punches accumulate.
Wolfram born in Tonga, but now moved to New Zealand at the age of 5. Attended Auckland University, was a star rugby player. When the Olympics came around, he had a better opportunity to represent the country of France, the country of his birth. He went in that direction, qualified in a tournament there. I tell you, it was big when he went back to Tonga after that medal.
Oh yeah, they carried him around and he's still losing. He's a big parade. He's
working free in there. Tonga.
He said that all his power box, he started at the age of 19. He was a teenage program.
Okay, stop! Yeah, which is better than having a teenage working. Dan's not liking the same right now between these two. Well, Gonzalez really is kind of vicious with these punches and second for air.
Well, that's a fight that's trying to terminate his career. This is a horrible pressure on the judges. Leaning against the ropes, he looks winded, he's showing signs of fatigue, mouth wide open. Yeah, he's hanging out.
Gonzalez has got to win this fight here tonight. So far, he's having trouble.
These little punches accumulate, and watch these little shots. They don't look hard, they don't look debilitating, but believe me, they add up. They make the accumulation of punches upstairs. Gonzalez is laying these devices. He's a European.
Oh, my foot.
badly on punch count by Wolfram. And Mills Lane has given Wolfram another round with his score of 39-37. Wolfram, of course, does not change a man. I'll tell you, Gonzalez has just had a wonderful amateur career. He's a sensation computer. He defected, though, in 1991. He was a computer team in Finland. Called Luis de Cubas. He represents a lot of the Cuban fighters and asked the Finnish government at that point in the war.
He says he knows how important this fight is, Gonzalez does. He says, I am so confident. Really take confident.
Jerry Wright warning Gonzalez again, excuse me, Sean, for the holding. He said, last time I'm going to warn you.
Gonzalez is not even one of them. He's not. He's got to get that jab moving. He's got to get
Wolfram out of the end of his right hand. And he's trying to connect
the fight.
Wolfram's smothering the punches of Gonzalez. And Wolfram is clinching.
There's the first good punch from Chief. And that was a good right hand to the body. Now suddenly comes apart with a left jab. Prior to those two punches, not really. Gonzalez just looks like he's got
the hands are free. Right out of there. Come on. Right out of that.
And he goes back to the corner. Gonzalez really hears it.
Down here at the El Paso County Coliseum, blowing the action of the heavyweights. They want Gonzalez to really fight a little more and not hold so much. And now suddenly he comes over with a right hand. Wolfram walked into that one. And Wolfram took it well, however, and comes forward right away. So in the last minute, Gonzalez did a little bit more here in round five. Now we go up to Barry Tompkins and Mills Lane upstairs, bro.
All right, thanks very much, Rich. I have a couple of observations regarding Gonzalez. One is that if he's wearing orthotics, I think he put him in his shoes backwards because he hasn't taken a forward step. The other thing is he keeps changing trainers, and I forgot to ask him why, and I realize now I think they probably wanted him to train.
That may be a fact. He's not making a good fight. The other kid's making the fight, and I think the other kid's out front. We'll have to see how it goes the next round with the other kids winning the fight.
All right, I don't think there's any question about that. I think there's a big question about our fight upcoming, and I promise you this one is going to be an action fight. Relatively speaking, it absolutely has to be. It features Luisita Espinosa as he defends his featherweight championship against Juan Carlos Ranchero Ramirez. This guy is a tough hombre.
Ramirez is a complete fighter. He is good, and he will find out what the other kid can fight.
And he gets an experienced fighter in Luisito Espinosa, who has seen it all.
All right, here we go now into round number six. Wolf Graham and Jorge Luis Gonzalez. Gonzalez for 5 rounds and 2 minutes. Showed us nothing, and then suddenly in the last minute, though, he began to come to life a little bit. Let's see if we can carry that on here to this round.
You may have heard
a chant in the last round here from the fans that they were chanting in Spanish. Apparently they went to the scintillating action. They were chanting,
Right hand.
Overhand right by Gonzalez. He might have got a couple times. That was blood in the eye of Wolfram.
He's hurt.
Blood on the left eye.
been leaning up against the ring. Can't afford to really catch the rest, but he's going to get those shots.
Sure you can. It doesn't take much energy on your legs.
Breathing is so important. And this fight, Gonzalez is not taking those deep breaths. Gonzalez is really beginning to feel something like winding up a little bit. Look at that light. The light hand's coming quick.
He's got a lot of good tools. I haven't seen it in this fight. He rolls up by the hand. He comes back. Come down, Paul makes him low. With the shoulder behind the hand. Gonzalez is punching down with that right hand.
Gonzalez has been a disappointment so far. Biggest win probably the Snipes was finished revive a career.
That was good. 39-7-1-2-4.
But even he's been disappointed. He was so embarrassed and angry with himself.
All
right, they're coming to the end of round six. The corner's going to have some work to do now in that eye of Wolf Brown. Six. Wolf Brown will go back to the corner now. Phil Torrance will get to work on that eye.
Head because he's so hot. He threw his body heat down. Threw the temperature down.
Now, Wolf Graham is still throwing more punches than Gonzalez, but Gonzalez is landing the better punches in that last round.
Okay, come out now.
Mills Lane scored that last round for Gonzalez, so he has him down by 2 points. Gonzalez looking a little miffed at the referee, Jerry Wright, breaking that clinch. And he goes right back to his holding.
Come on,
so far, he's a double cut. He's looking out a little quicker here on this one.
Seems like he got his second win in that sixth round.
Wolf Graham's going to have to fight through having a puffy eye and a puffy left eye. And plus, he's going further now. He's all gone in his career. This is into the seventh round. He's never been this far. And in his only sixth rounder, he lost when he faded down the stretch. Certainly much better shot than 315 pounds, Sean.
Yeah, that gym is out
there. You can't stand around there.
That gym is not in shape.
He's down with those hands low when he gets his man up against the wall.
so then when they left, good.
Seconds to go in round seven. We come to the end of the round. Wolf Graham with one big right. Back to the corner with Wolf Graham. Fell towards in front of him. Hedgman Lewis just on the outside of the ropes.
Wolf Graham. You want this, you gotta go get it. You want that? You gotta go get it just now. You got one punch and you lay it in there. Okay? You got to make it. Okay, okay. This is that spot, okay? You got to go to the finish line.
Can't teach an old dog new tricks. Gonzalez was still Gonzalez. And we have learned, I think, that Wolf Graham has a long, long way to go.
He's got a long way to go. You know, heavyweights just don't make for good fights, really. We have the other guys like we got coming up. But it was a drag. But I think that Wolfgang knows him up by 1 point, I think.
All right, let's take a look at some of the highlights. Wolf Graham won the early rounds. I don't think there's too much question about that. I think the biggest question is, did Gonzalez win the later rounds? This is action early in the fight. We moved to round number four. Wolf Graham, again, right on top of Gonzalez. Gonzalez very rarely took more than a step off those ropes.
You know, when the guy's got more than that, he just doesn't extend himself. And that's the terrible thing about it. The guy's got talent, but he won't use it.
Yeah, he does a couple of things very well. John Brady talked about how he cranks his punches. And you saw that. If he would do it with any consistency, he has a good jab, and he does have some power. But he just is a lazy fighter.
That's true. Absolutely true.
So now it's in the hands of the judges, and they're going to decide who wins this fight. This is a fight I would have to think that both men really need. If Gonzalez doesn't get it, school's just about out. These are the final punch numbers, and higher connect percentage, of course, for Gonzalez. Wolf Graham, as the guys told you all along, threw more punches. So Wolf Graham needs it. Gonzalez needs it. Who's going to win it? We'll go to Michael Buffer and find out. Michael?
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the Budweiser scorecards. Arturo Servin scores the bout 76-76. He has it even. Levi Martinez scores it 78-74. Frank Adams scores it 78-74 for the winner by majority decision. Wolf Graham.
Well, the early rounds obviously won it for Wolf Graham. The crowd boos, but Mills, I kind of have the idea. They probably would have booed no matter who won the fight.
They wanted the fight to be over. Heck, they didn't want to see any more of them. They just wanted to see them.
We're pitching a role of Wolf Graham's people now. What do you say to them? Yeah, you got the W. You're back on track. But what do you need to do?
You've got to go to the gym. You've got to get in shape. You've got to carry around still too much weight. And you've got to get in the bob and weave and punch more.
All right, we're going to go to center of the ring right now. Sean O'Grady is with the winner. Sean?
What about that scoring, Wolf Graham? Did you believe that? Were you scared?
I thought I notched the head in the fights and I came off some of the last few rounds. So, yeah.
Did you see it that way?
No, I see it that way now. I thought I notched the head just, but the majority is fine.
New style tonight. How did that feel?
Wake up, baby. Well, he was a boxer. He ran away from me. Perhaps I didn't get enough time to get inside and work his body. But he did really well this time.
Now, Wolf Graham, he hurt you back in the fifth and sixth round. I thought you buckled a little bit. Were you ever in trouble?
No, I had my head back. Where it was in my feet under me. And I managed to survive for it. But he was a shaky moment, yeah.
Is this a message to the other heavyweights that Wolf Graham is back?
On his way back. I'm still about 10 kilos from where I am. And once I get there, watch out.
Oh, watch out is right. All right, Wolf Graham, he is back. Now runs his record to 16-1 with 13 KOs. Barry, he knows what he's got ahead of him.
Yeah, he really does. And one of the things I really like about Wolf Graham is he's a very, very honest guy. And I think the operable word